one of the reasons why I created open source projects was because the current ecosystem of open source was not friendly. It was not supportive. It was it was hard. There was people with egos. There were it was rude. It was obnoxious. People wanted to show off. People wanted to put other people down. You know, the early 2000s was a very difficult time if people wanted to be part of open source, and it required a very calloused personality. And honestly, I'm just not good with that sort of stuff. It's not me. You know, someone would put me down or something, and I'd just kind of, you know, not want to be part of that project and go do something else.
Which is completely sane, you know, but And there's so, still too much of that now, but less so than I remember in those early years.
So I found it easier to create open source projects and set a different tone. You know, I have created other open source projects, and out of them, as I said before, you know, one of the things that I've done through all of them is, you know, I've created a very, you know, inclusive and supportive community. We've had some people that were condescending, and I would, you know, quite often, even at the beginning, I would IRC message people, or I would call them up and I would say, yeah, that is an inappropriate way to talk to people. And they're like, well, he's asking a dumb question. You know, they could learn that if they go back through the logs, or if they can learn that if they did this, or if they did the other thing. It's like, so what? How much time does it really take just to tell someone, even if you've told them 50 times, how do you exit Vim? Just tell them again, right? It's not just the attitude and the perspective that you create when you say, you know, go check logs, or go, you know, Google that, or go come up with an answer. You know, the answer's out there. It immediately just shuts people down, right? Yeah, it could be an appropriate response, but just as easily you can just say, here's how you do it. Little things like that, I found, just went a really long way. I mean, the Singularity mailing list, as of today, it is very active, and people feel very comfortable even asking, you know, questions that have been asked, and being open and willing to ask things. Yeah. And it's, you know, so I still do that today. Singularity is a good example of that.